all you need to know. The Bloomberg Quint podcast that prepares you for the day's business.
Brought to you by IIFL Securities, India's leading broking firm.
Good morning. You're listening to the All You Need to Know podcast from Bloomberg Quint, and I'm Alex Matthew. Today is the 4th of April. Now, as I always tell you, you'll find all the live market action on the website BloombergQuint.com or on our social media channels. But today, the big highlight is going to be the result of the first meeting of the Monetary Policy Committee this financial year. Nearly all the economists polled by Bloomberg expect the MPC to cut the repo rate by 25 basis points to 6.25%. Tune in to find out what happens and do look for the analysis on the website. But that's to do with the short term. In the next few months, however, the monsoons could give policymakers headaches. Private weather forecaster SkyMet said yesterday that monsoon rains are more likely to be below normal this year, with warmer Pacific waters even raising drought fears. The forecaster expects the seasonal rainfall to come in at 93% of the long period average between June and September. Remember, anything less than 90% is considered a deficient monsoon. Now, as much as 90% of the loans handed out by ILNFS Financial Services have turned bad, again highlighting the challenge the government-appointed board faces in bringing the group back to solvency. Just for context, IDBI Bank, which previously held the ignominious record of worst asset quality, had a bad loan ratio of just under 30% as of December. Lenders to Jet Airways are finalizing a plan to infuse 1,500 crore rupees into the struggling carrier through debt against promoter shares. The consortium of lenders led by State Bank of India may ask the airline's founder Naresh Goyal and international partner Etihad Airways to pledge part of their stake in the company to approve the debt. That's a Bloomberg Quint report. It was separately reported that Naresh Goyal had said that he had agreed to every term and condition laid down by lenders to Jet Airways to ensure a timely release of funds. In other news, Reliance Jio Digital Services has acquired artificial intelligence firm Haptik in a 700 crore rupee deal. Reliance will now hold about 87% of the business, with the rest being held by Haptik founders and employees through stock options. In international news, Bloomberg has reported that the trade deal that the US and China are working towards would give Beijing until 2025 to meet commitments on commodity purchases and would allow American companies to wholly own enterprises in the Asian nation. Trump's top economic advisor spoke of progress in the talks but cautioned that a final deal remains elusive. Britain's parliament has approved a cross-party deal to block a no-deal Brexit that's scraped through by a single vote. Brexiteers no longer have the option of a no-deal exit to fight for, so they're left backing Prime Minister Theresa May and whatever she comes up with in talks with her rivals, or facing a potentially long extension of EU membership. Now, talking about international markets, US equity markets rose further overnight. The benchmark S&P 500 finished positive for a fifth day, equaling the longest winning streak in 2 months. American equities had slumped midday after Bloomberg News reported that millions of Facebook user records were found on cloud computing servers. Treasury yields continued their climb from recent two-year lows, while the dollar declined against major peers. In Asia this morning, the three early rises in Asia have begun mixed, with two of the three, Japan's Nikkei and the South Korean Kospi, both searching for direction. With that, it's over to Darshan Mehta for the trade setup for the day in India. Morning, Darshan. How are we looking on policy day?
Hi, Alex. Good morning. Good morning, everyone. The global cues seem decent at this point of time. As of now, the SCX Nifty is indicating a positive outlook. But lots of stocks that we need to watch out for. Watch out for Reliance Industries. Small announcement there. Its arm enters into a definitive business transfer agreement with Haptik for around 700 crores. Reliance will hold almost 87% stake in the target company. Now, Haptik is a conversational artificial intelligence platform. Morgan Stanley says that the deal will bring conversational AI-enabled devices with multilingual capabilities. Indiabulls Housing Finance came out with their fourth quarter update. They say they will deliver 17 to 19% PAT growth in the current financial year. They hold cash and cash equivalents of almost 27,500 crores and plan to raise a total of 26,000 crores in the next four quarters. Nalco, the aluminium production came out for the year 4,40,000 tons versus 4,26,000 tons for last year. It says that the net sales for the fiscal will be 11,397 crores versus 9,376 crores. Godrej Properties enters into a joint venture with a developer to develop 4.25 acres property in Mumbai. Suven Life again gets patents in Israel, Japan, New Zealand and Sri Lanka. A small company called Kanoria Chemicals, they have commissioned its plant in Canada for the production of automotive and industrial electronics. In terms of bulk deals, Fidelity bought in almost 1.3% in SH Kelkar, while ICICI Prudential Mutual Fund sold in 1.25 lakh shares in AstraZeneca Pharma. In terms of corporate announcement, Bharat Road Network price band has been revised to 10%. Monnet Ispat MT Educare moved to the short-term ASM framework. In terms of brokerages on Amara Raja, Edelweiss has downgraded the counter to a hold on the uncertainty over future technology development. Morgan Stanley is saying that the key investor concern is Johnson Controls 24% stake. But according to them, and when they spoke to Johnson Control, the company has said that Amara Raja's stake will go to Brookfield. Nomura is saying that the company may take some time to find new partners, which can affect the long-term growth if it decides to stay out of the Brookfield acquired business. Morgan Stanley has downgraded Eicher Motors to an equal weight from overweight. They say that the volume slowdown lowers the margin visibility. PI Industries will be in focus. HSBC raises the target price to 1250 from earlier 1015. They say they are seeing signs of recovery in the global agrochemical markets. And Nomura has initiated on the small finance bank. The preferred pick is Equitas at this point of time. So Equitas is a buy. AU Small Finance is a neutral and Ujjivan is a reduce. The pecking order is Equitas with a target price of 165, then followed by AU Small Finance with a target price of 590. And then it's Ujjivan, in which they see a potential downside. The target price there is 315. But there's much more you need to know before trade actually starts. For that, log on to our website bloombergquint.com and click on the All You Need to Know tab, and you will be prepared for morning trade.
Thanks, Arshan, and thank you all for listening in. This is Alex Matthews signing off. Have a lovely day.
I hope you enjoyed listening to All You Need to Know. Did you know that you can listen to this show on the IVM Podcast app? On the IVM Podcast app, along with this, we have a number of other shows which you think you'll enjoy. Listen to Cyrus Says with Cyrus Brocha as the host. Listen to Paisa Vaisa with Anupam Gupta. The Seen and the Unseen with Amit Verma. Or Shunya One, hosted by Shiladitya Mukhopadhyay and myself. Check out the IVM Podcast app to get more talk content that you will enjoy.